The construction of station NL1 is complete and fully supplied. However, the remaining Rebel and Bakuni forces continue to harass and threaten our interests in this system. Thanks to your recent efforts in capturing high-ranking Rebel officers, we now know they have a small fleet nearby, along with the remaining Bakuni pirate forces who have joined them. We also know they still haven't given up on the possibility of defeating us by destroying NL1 and killing Vice Admiral Thrawn before we can fully establish a foothold here. Killing Thrawn would certainly be a major victory for the Rebels, given his tactical prowess. With this information, the Admiral is preparing a trap to draw out this enemy fleet and crush them once and for all. Thrawn himself will be the bait, and under the pretense of an inspection, will be boarding NL1 while the Victory-class Star Destroyer Stalwart leaves the area to escort a final convoy to the station. We want to create the impression that the station will be vulnerable to a larger assault without the Stalwart around to defend it, and with Thrawn himself on board, he believes the Rebels will finally believe it's worth the risk to commit their entire fleet to eliminate both the station and Thrawn in a single heavy strike, especially once we leak this information about Thrawn's visit. In reality, the Stalwart will be making a short jump to a nearby system to rendezvous with an interdictor cruiser and additional fire support, so if and when the Rebels strike, we can close the trap, prevent their escape, and crush their remaining forces in one fell swoop. This won't be without its dangers though. The station and Thrawn himself will be vulnerable, but we also need to do our best to draw out the Rebel fleet by trying to make NL1 seem as vulnerable as possible. To this end, if the Rebels try to draw out our forces before committing their main fleet, we will oblige by sending your squadron, TIE Interceptor Group Gamma, and the modified frigate Ludwig out to meet them. You will be flying an assault gunboat designated Tower 1 with 5 wingmen and armed with concussion missiles. Modified corvettes Horvus and our remaining TIE fighters will hold station close to NL1 to provide cover fire from enemy craft making strafing runs. We expect a sizable combined force of both Rebel and Bakuni ships, including all manner of starfighters, assault transports, and any remaining corvettes or other capital ships they may have in their fleet. Also, be on the lookout for any shuttles attempting to escape with Rebel officers on board. The NL1 installation is now complete, but Rebel and pirate forces are still trying to disrupt our efforts to pacify this sector. To this end, Vice Admiral Thrawn has devised a plan to draw out their main fleet and crush them once and for all. Thrawn himself will act as bait by performing an inspection of the installation whilst the Victory-class Star Destroyer Stalwart jumps away, leaving the area vulnerable. Our spies will deliberately leak this information to ensure it piques the Rebels' interest. Thrawn hopes this will be tempting enough for them to commit their main fleet in an attempt to eliminate both him and the station. Killing Thrawn certainly would be a major victory for them and an opportunity they can't pass up. The Rebels are likely to first send in a small force to try and draw our remaining ships away from the station, so to make it look good, we will happily oblige them. It is important we make the station appear as vulnerable as possible. Modified corvettes Horvus will hold position by the station to help screen it from enemy bombing runs, while the modified frigate Ludwig will provide fighter and anti-capital support. If and when the main Rebel fleet shows up, the Stalwart will quickly return with reinforcements, including an interdictor, to prevent their escape.
Heads up, looks like a Rebel scout just entered the area. Do not engage, let them take a good look. scout has jumped away. Get ready for an attack. A small rebel strike force has entered the area. Assault gunboats Tau and TIE Interceptor Gamma move to intercept. The Ludwig will support. All other ships hold position around the station. They're trying to draw as many ships away as possible. So let's make it look good. We want them to fall into our trap.
Hey, one attacking craft dead ahead. Hey, one, you better shake that bandit off your stick.
Another bandit down.
This is three.
I've got a search and firing at me.
I've got a sergeant firing at me. This is five. I'm having trouble over here.
Another man down.
firing it!
Another bandit down. It's 6. Order acknowledged. Using your target for attack.
Trouble over here.
Fantastic work. The enemy fleet has been utterly crushed. You may return to the Stalwart's hangar.
This is Vice Admiral Thrawn to all craft. You have all done an excellent job today and performed a great service for the Empire, particularly you, Tau One.
Report to the debriefing room at once.
How are the repairs proceeding?
Damage caused by the Rebel attack is almost repaired.
Excellent. I want this installation fully operational within the hour.
Yes, sir. We will be prepared for any further Rebel attack.
Superb work. The trap worked perfectly, and we successfully eliminated the entire combined Rebel and Pirate fleet, fully securing this sector for the Empire. The NL-1 station took some minor damage during the assault, but repairs are already underway. Vice Admiral Thrawn is issuing commendation medals to all our pilots for their valiant work, and in particular had special praise for your personal efforts. Keep this up and you will surely make it far within the Imperial Navy.